Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rohit Khurana, your host on Intellect Digest, and today we have with us the HTC Desire 310. This is a mid-range phone, rather I should say entry-range phone from the HTC, and it comes with some basic features and some basic set of specifications. I'll give you a quick review of the same in this video. I'll talk about all the important factors that matter to you before you make the purchase decision to buy HTC Desire 310. I'll talk about what color options it comes in, the SIM card options, I'll talk about the size, form factor, build quality, screen size, resolution, as well as the touchscreen responsiveness when it comes to gaming as well as using your phone in day-to-day life. We'll also talk about the camera quality, the rear camera, the front camera, I'll give you some camera samples. I'll talk about the audio-video performance, consuming multimedia information on your phone, using it as a real smartphone. I'll also talk about the user interface as well as softwares that you get pre-installed on the HTC Desire 310. We'll also talk about the benchmark scores, battery life, specifications, and all you need to know about the HTC Desire 310. Let's get started. The HTC Desire 310 is a 3G enabled phone and comes in two colors. The one we have is white in color and comes with a white color back shell. However, the front is black only, and in black color you get a back shell of black color as well. This phone comes with a small display of 4.5 inch, which may not be small to some users, but considering today's standards where we get 5 inch screen on most of the phones, this looks a bit small compared to the other phones that we are used to of seeing. It comes with a display resolution of 480 by 840 pixel. It comes with a 5 megapixel rear camera which comes without flash, and there is a VGA camera at front. Let me open the back flap and show you what lies beneath. Under the shell you get the access to 2000 mAh battery by HTC. This is a user removable battery, and there are two full size SIM card slots. SIM 1 is capable of running 3G, whereas SIM 2 is not capable of running 3G, it runs only 2G data. There is a micro SD card slot for memory expansion. Since it has only 4GB internal memory, you can expand the memory by adding a micro SD card here. Giving you a quick hardware tour of the phone looks pretty easy to hold, is curvy and nicely designed. The build seemed to be very nice, considering that this is not a very expensive phone. The materials used here on the HTC Desire are good and premium in quality. On the right hand side of the phone you get two keys. This is the power or wake up key and the volume rocker key on the top. The keys are good in quality and are tactile, seem to be something of a polycarbonate material. The bottom gets a microphone hole. This is the primary microphone hole in the indent on the bezel. The bezel is black and glossy over here. On top you get a standard micro USB port for charging as well as data syncing, followed by a 3.5 mm standard audio jack. The front of the phone has HTC branding here, and the software buttons are provided within the display itself. There are no touch capacitive buttons on the bezels. There is a front facing camera which is on the top. This is a VGA camera and large speaker mesh which is provided here for clear sound reception, as well as it gives a good visual appeal to the phone. Talking about the display quality and the display color, it seems to be a bit dull. Let me increase the brightness to see if it can improve or not. There is no ambient light sensor on this phone, which is why you don't see an automatic brightness mode. This is the maximum brightness, which is still okay, and it is not the best that we have seen on entry level phones, but it is still visible in bright light. The quality of display and the color reproduction could have been better. There is a slight blue tinge in the display, but it still works out to be okay. To give you a fair idea of the touchscreen quality, let me quickly play a game and show you how accurately it controls the game. The speaker works out to be pretty loud. There is a speaker cutout provided on the rear down here, and we are playing the Frontline Commando game, which is decent on graphics. This phone uses Mali 400 MP GPU. And the speaker is fairly loud. Let me turn down the volume a little, and we are able to control the player very accurately. So the touch screen is good. The responsiveness is quite precise. The display angles, however, are not very good. As I turn the display this side, it turns dark very soon. So the viewing angles are not that impressive, but the accuracy and the touch response of the screen is very accurate. I'm able to control my player very well, and the graphics are also rendering fine. So when it comes to touchscreen quality and graphics quality, I'm impressed with the graphics rendering as well as touchscreen quality, but the viewing angles are not very good. Now let's talk about the camera of the phone. There is a 5 megapixel camera at rear which comes without flash. Let me take a few pictures for you and show you a live demo of how the camera performs. There seems to be no touch to focus, however this seems to be an autofocus camera. I've just taken a shot and the pictures come out to be average. They are not very sharp and they are not very crisp. The quality of pictures is just about average from the rear camera. However, you get some modes over here, which includes the automatic mode, HDR, face beauty mode, panorama mode, macro, inside panorama, scene mode, and smile detect mode. It will automatically click a picture when it detects a smile in the shot. And there are standard settings menu provided here in which you can select the white balance, picture display resolution, etc. There is also self timer which is provided, and there is a 40 shot burst mode. You can also record full high definition 1080p videos with this phone, and it can also record time lapse videos with the software interface provided. There is also EIS or electrical image stabilization within the video shooting, so when you are taking videos you can stabilize your videos a bit using the EIS mode. Now let me quickly give you a demonstration of the video playback quality and the audio playback quality on this phone. I'll quickly stream a video from our YouTube channel. As you can see, the colors are coming out to be okay. Not the best that we have seen on the displays of phones in this price segment, but still okay. The display could have been slightly better, but the audio is very loud and very clear from the speakers which are provided at the rear. It is very easy to hear the audio from the speakers. Let me try put it on the surface. The sound gets a bit muffled when I put it on a flat surface, but it's still okay. And the audio comes out to be really nice. Let me quickly give you a demonstration of the sound quality as well. I'll play some music tracks on this phone to show you how loud it is. So as you can hear, it is very loud and the speaker quality is very good. Now let me quickly show you the benchmarks and talk about the specifications of this phone. So I'll first show you the AnTuTu benchmark score on the HTC Desire 310. On our test, we got a score of 17,178, which is not bad considering that this device is priced under $200 or around 10,000 rupees. It uses a 1.3 GHz quad-core CPU by MediaTek, has 512 MB of RAM, which is not a lot, but still it manages to give us a good performance when it comes to benchmarks. It runs Android Jelly Bean 4.2.2 and we believe that some updates will be rolled out soon. There is Mali 400 GPU. Let me also show you the Neera Mark 2 graphics benchmark scores which we ran on this phone, and we got a score of 68.9 frames per second. This is surprising. We have not seen such high scores on any phones, but this phone manages to give very good graphics. Since the graphics resolution is not that high, it is not that difficult to render graphics for this phone, and it runs a Mali 400 MP GPU, which is fairly capable. Now let me quickly talk about the software interface. The HTC comes up with its own Sense UI, and we get the same Sense UI on the HTC Desire 310 as well. We see this app drawer which scrolls vertically, and there are some special docks which are at the bottom. So even when you are in the app drawer, you have these docked applications, so you can keep your quickly used applications here. For example, I use my Gmail a lot, so I can easily dock it to this dock at the bottom and it will always stay here. I can keep WhatsApp and other applications here, and when you swipe from the left to right, you get this Sense UI, the HTC Sense Blink feed that you get here. You get customization options where you can add the topics of your choice and you will get the updates on this screen very easily. Talking about the battery life, there is 2000 mAh battery provided on this phone, and considering that the display size is not that large and the display resolution is also not very large, added to that the processor on this phone is also not very demanding. So all these factors make the battery life of this phone really good. You can easily go one full day without a charge on a moderate usage, and for light users it may even last for more than one day when it comes to the battery life on HTC Desire 310. Summarizing our review of the HTC Desire 310, we find that the build quality is better than average. we find that the battery life is really good, but the camera is not that high in quality. There is also no inbuilt flash on this camera, so you may not be able to take good pictures in the low light conditions. The software interface, however, is a highlight on this phone and it gives you some really good user interface experience. The display viewing angles are a bit disappointing, but the graphics performance of games etc. on the HTC Desire 310 is really good and impressive. All in all, under $200 or 10,000 rupees, this is a good choice if you are looking to buy a branded smartphone with a good build quality and are ready to compromise on the camera quality and display quality. This is all we have on our detailed review of the HTC Desire 310. We hope you like this video. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up by pressing the like button below. For more such videos, stay subscribed by pressing the subscribe button. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.